Yes, thank you so much, Evangelist. Tonight we have several questions, three questions. And the first question reads, my husband is a sinner. And I cannot get him to change. Nothing I say seems to help him. What do you suggest? They would like to know, Mr. Evangelist.
Oh my, what a husband to have. But you know, the lady who wrote this question, she loves her man. So you got to commend her. She loves her man and she wants him to be in the kingdom. So we must, wherever she is tonight, I don't know, maybe she's just looking at me right now. She loves her husband and we need to commend her. But you know, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 16, here it says something that is so special. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 16, an encouragement. Let your light so shine before men that they may what? See your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Now, it is good that this wife, she is trying. All I'm going to say is this. Continue to do all the best you can. Cook him his best meal. And sometimes you just need to have dinner candlelight. And to let him know it is because Jesus has blessed you, you are taking care of him. And also, treat him in a way that he will always see that you are striving. Pray for him. In the bedroom, pray for him and call his name in prayer for him to hear that you love him and you don't want to be separated when Jesus comes. And we will be definitely giving the prayer man this question and as this particular request, and they will continue to pray for you. Thank you.
The next question says, Mr. Evangelist, I would like to know why you keep calling doom for the Bahamas. You said earthquake in Haiti, earthquake in Jamaica, earthquake in this place and that place. You said that it must come to the Bahamas. There's power in the tongue. I don't think you should keep saying that.
One little man like me can upset everything in the Bahamas with my tongue. And you know, it is clear that I share with you that we can be prepared for an earthquake. And when we started out, you remember what happened in New Zealand, okay? What happened in New Zealand, it was about our first week, I think it was our first week, we had that earthquake in New Zealand. And we were just a few days ago, there was a tugger earthquake in Japan. Now, on the Ring of Fire, you know that the Bahamas is not really far from the Ring of Fire, because the Bahamas is where, both on, in the Pacific and the Atlantic, we're right between, all right? Everybody know a little geography right now. So we are close to the Pacific Ocean, and in the Pacific Ocean, you have the Ring of Fire. There is a fault that's there that has been discovered for a number of years, and so the earthquakes that are taking place are actually on that belt in the Pacific. Which means now that the earthquake in Japan, it said, did you know that there were waves that reached all the way up to California? You heard that? And damaged about one boat, and there's a man that they're trying to find because he was standing on the beach trying to take a picture of the water coming to it. And now he's missing. They can't find him. Now, for the wave to take place all the way in Japan, and you felt the effect in California. Now, we are in the middle of all of this. Jamaica and Haiti on this side, and Japan on that side. We find ourselves in the middle. It will not be a surprise if this year we experience an earthquake in the Bahamas. So we just have to pray that whenever this takes place, that nobody will be at school, the buildings, the high-rise buildings, nobody will be there, will be in a safe place. So let us pray that if it comes and when it comes, we all will be safe.
The next question is baptism necessary? What about the thief that died on the cross?
Okay, this is a very important question. The thief on the cross was the thief on the cross. Now, you are not a thief on the cross. All right now. And the Bible says that John chapter 3 And verse 5, it says here, Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be what? Born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot what? Enter into the kingdom of God." There was only one man on that cross, not a thousand. And so Jesus wants us to understand that we must be born again. Jesus knew everything about him. Jesus made special arrangement for him, not for us, because he has given each one of us the opportunity to accept salvation and be baptized. Thank you very much, Mr. Question Man, and we look forward for tomorrow night.